Thank you very much for such a kind introduction. I am not new to Hyderabad. I frequent Hyderabad every year. But at the outset, I want to thank the leaders and the servant leaders of Sanskriti Foundation. The work that you are doing among educators, among young people, among the citizens of Bharat is extremely important because, as it was outlined in the introductory remarks, that if our young people are not rooted to our culture, it might be tough to translate their energy, their thoughts, their intellect into actions that are beneficial for the larger humanity, for the larger mankind. It is a brilliant day to be talking about social entrepreneurship for youth. There was a larger theme that was suggested that I will touch upon today. Youth, if we talk about it, what better a day that on the 23rd of January, as the whole world celebrates Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, we sit here having a conversation with educators, with young people from all across our country. For a Zoom session, I think a number close to near 1,000, I think over 700 or around 750 when I joined. It is just brilliant. It just shows the kind of interest that Sanskriti Foundation has continued to arouse all across. Now, I'm going to quickly talk a little bit about Netaji and a little bit about Swamiji and talk about what should we do. Because, you know, I am introduced at many platforms as a social entrepreneur, but there is a very interesting part of the story that for the first several years, I did not even know that I was one. It was only later that I probably walked into the vocabulary and began to understand that what I am doing is called social entrepreneurship. Because what I was doing when I started at the age of 16, for me then and today, it remains Swamiji's work. And on 23rd of January, when we celebrate Netaji, Netaji probably said something similar. He said that if Swami Vivekananda would have been alive today, I would have been at his feet. I would have devoted my life to do his work, and that work he did. And that is the reason why today we are celebrating his birthday with such great eminence. So what can young people do all across our country? So I'll not focus too much on social entrepreneurship, because once you start acting, you will be an entrepreneur, you will be a social entrepreneur, you will be an activist, you will be a leader. That vocabulary let the world give you. What should you do? Where to get started? Many people here, probably this is my first engagement or first interaction with you of any kind, virtual or physical. And for that reason, I want to give a quick rundown of how I got started and how I got here. As Sri Dr. Vivek Modi ji pointed out, for the first 12 years of my life, I did not go to a school. I grew up in small towns and villages of Bihar. And these were places where there were no such resources that we imagine when we talk about cities in general or access in general. So my parents decided to teach me at home, and it was a threefold process in which they taught us, which I like to repeat again and again, because many times we are looking for the secret sauce. We are looking for that one key element that transforms somebody's life. And if there is any, this is the education that probably has built me forward. The first part of my education was that in the small rented houses where we lived in small towns and villages of Bihar, on every wall of that house, my parents had pasted quotations of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa, Ma Sharada Devi, and Swami Vivekananda, and other great men and women of our times and those who came before us. And every morning, we had to wake up, and before we did anything, we used to read the quotations of Thakur Ma and Swamiji aloud in English and in Hindi, and then we used to get to work. This was the first part of my education. Many people ask me, when did you decide to dedicate yourself or devote yourself in this work? And it is always tough for me to answer, because the software that I carry was probably built, wired, and coded at a very young age when I was reading those quotations of Thakur Mahan Swamiji. The second part of my education was that the places where we lived, newspapers used to come one day late. And yet my parents had mandated it for us to read newspapers every day. And every day, as I read those newspapers, I used to read stories of young men and women from different parts of our country who would secure a scholarship, win a competition, or represent India. And I also wanted to do the same, but I was not enrolled in a school, so I could not have participated in any of these competitions, in any of these opportunities. So I picked up a simple habit. And that I hope my friends will tell you, the power of habit. Swamiji continues to talk about the power within. He talks about the power of observation, concentration, habits, and different things. This is the power of a habit. One simple thing that I started doing was all these news stories that I read and wished that I could also participate in those opportunities and could not. I just used to write down the name of those opportunities, the month in which that news came out, who can participate and how. I did that for a good number of years. And then at the age of 12, when my family moved to the city of Patna, that is, we moved with our mother, father was still posted in rural areas of Bihar, I started participating in all those opportunities. That was the second part of my education. The third part of the education was that parents brought books and notebooks home and they taught us and we self-taught ourselves. The first part built the software that would power my journey forward. The second part, of course, introduced me to the rest of the world, global opportunities, gave me enough exposure, reading lines of those newspaper. And interestingly, once I came to school, I started participating in every single opportunity that was there. Fast forward that story, by the time I was in standard 12th, I had represented India in over 6 different countries and won close to 200 local, national, and international competitions. Now, this, I think, is the point where the fundamental difference was made because of having followed Swamiji's ideas so purely and so passionately in my life. I could have been one of those young people who would have decided that I am doing all these things because I worked hard, I am smart, and, you know, I am special. But interestingly, because of Swamiji's teaching, because of Swamiji's thoughts, I continue to introspect at all these platforms, and there were two very important things that I found. And I know many of us either find these two observations or we are part of it, those who are suffering. When I used to come back from these major countries and platforms and competitions, I would come back and I would tell my friends the stories of the hotel, the flight, the city, but I also used to tell them the questions that were asked, the ideas young people put forward. And many times, young boys and girls from small towns, villages, and districts of Bihar who were studying with me in my classroom, they knew answers to questions that everybody missed out on a global platform. Many times their ideas were so much brighter and so much stronger than any idea that was put forward at a global platform. So I used to tell my friends, oh, you should have been there. And I was quick enough to understand and realize that it was not that my friends were not smart or hardworking or special. It was just that they did not know that these opportunities exist. These opportunities that I had noted down from a newspaper for so long, and that is how I knew it. So I started participating. So that is how I had started participating in these things. So this was my first observation, that if you do not know an opportunity, you do not get that opportunity. The second observation was that at these global platforms, when young people from all across the world would come in and talk about education, development, access to clean drinking water, literacy, alleviating poverty. Most young people who represented India, they did not come from a background like mine. They came from a world school or an international school that many times cost several lakh rupees, that is well above even the pay grade of many families across India where even both parents are working. And I used to wonder, will we be better served if at these global platforms, we had a girl child from a village of Rajasthan who had seen her mother go a kilometer and a half to fetch clean drinking water, would her ideas on access to clean drinking water better serve a global platform? Will her lived experiences better inspire and instill a want, a desire, and new ideas to solve that problem? And would we not be better served if we groomed her as a next generation leader, as opposed to parachuting leadership from outside? We have been colonized for 200 years, attacked for several hundred years. And somewhere what has that has done in the mindset of some who are very well educated also is that somebody from Massachusetts will come and solve the problem of Mumbai. That somebody from Mumbai will come and solve the problem of Muzaffarpur. Somebody from Muzaffarpur will go and solve the problem of a small village somewhere. We need to change that. India has always grown inside out. If Bharat has to grow, the Bharatiya Marg has to be taken. And that Marg has to come from within. Swamiji continued to talk about and focus on the point that all the power in the world is within you. It is you who has kept your hands on your eyes and cried that it is dark. For too long, we have cried darkness. While many of our role models all across the country have shown us light, when we talk about President Kalam, when we talk about E. Sridharan, when we talk about great men and women of our country who have shown us the light, we are inspired and reminded of what lies within us. But it is very important an observation that dexterity makes. And that observation is that many times for our children in small towns and villages of India, even President Kalam is a far off role model. He begins to feel like one person out of 1 billion. And that is why many kids begin to give up. They feel that, oh, maybe one gifted person becomes Kalam. One gifted person becomes Sridharan. So what does India need today? India needs local role models. The first girl child in a village to go to college. The first boy from a particular district to start something of his or her, of his own. The first child from a particular district to receive a full scholarship to study. These local role models raise the level of aspiration and achievement all across from where they come. Because those who come from that particular school, that particular community, that particular district, begin to feel that somebody who looks like me, talks like me, sits beside me, if that person can do it, I can do it as well. With that idea, dexterity is continuing to power the next generation of leaders. The twofold task that we continue to do in simple words, the first one is, if there is an opportunity for our children and youth, they should be the first ones to know about it. And that is what we do through Dex Connect, through which we reach close to 6.5 million children all across our country, more than 10 lakh, that is 1 million of them inside their classrooms on their notice board. Because we understand if the child does not know that these opportunities exist, the child will never be able to explore those. Many of us as educators, teachers, parents continue to complain that our children do not have interests. They are wasting their time. The question is, have we introduced them to a small science competition, to a small math competition, to a small essay writing competition, to a small painting competition, stamp making competition, whatever it may be? And that is why Dex Connect from a very young age begins to connect children with these opportunities that makes them more aware and more engaged in these fields. So that has been my journey so far. In the last 12 years, we've continued to build leaders for our country, leaders in different fields. Leadership too, we have made it about positions in our country, of course, through the media that likes to show, you know, only things that are very grand as ideas of leadership. At Dexterity, we tell our young children in small towns and villages of our country to the biggest metropolitans that leadership is what Swamiji talked about. Be and make. If you can write a letter, help somebody write a letter. If you can navigate your way through a problem, help somebody navigate the way. We tell our children that this evening, somewhere in a public maidan in this country, if a girl child helps another girl child learn how to play badminton better, that child is a leader. Somewhere in our country, somebody who does not know very good English or Hindi or but knows Kannada or Telugu or Odia, if that child helps an old widow write a letter in Telugu to get her widow pension card, that child is a leader. Some girl child at a government school who waits after school to help another girl child with two math problems, that child is a leader. Leadership has to be built inside out. And we need to tell our children right from a very young age that we are born learners and born leaders. So this is something to keep in mind. Social entrepreneurship opportunities for youth. I'll keep it simple. I'll not give you the business school jargons. It is very simple. Swami Vivekananda said that the national ideals of India are renunciation and service. You take that quotation is social entrepreneurship. Ideally, it should be entrepreneurship. If you look at the journey of those who made a lot of money, except for those who were unethical and crooked and had different ulterior motives, if you see, these were people who wanted to create value for the society. Those were the men and women who were able to build enterprises that served more and more people. For a social entrepreneur, if I have to add the word social, I think the renunciation part becomes slightly important. And that is, wherever you are, if you see that we can educate our children better and they are having a problem in getting good quality educational content or curriculum, build an ed tech company, build a set of small 3 rooms, start teaching. If you feel that affordable healthcare can reach more people, better education can reach more people, sports can lead to personality development, education about cultural heritage and cultural nationalism can build better citizens, whatever idea it is, whatever your way of seva can be, you take that forward. What is the renunciation part? The early days of building anything. Remember, entrepreneurship is a very recent word that people have started using. We've been building since ages. We've built gurukuls, we built monasteries, we built establishments that continue to take care of the world, and the world came to our shores to see that. So whenever you are building something, you'll have to do a lot of renunciation. That renunciation will be renunciation of wasting your time, renunciation of over dependence on profits or money or what will I get from it. So as you continue to renounce small bits, and on the other end, you passionately pursue service, you will be able to build something that is worthwhile. So that is the reason why I do not fall too much into the textbook definition of social entrepreneurship. Just identify a problem that you want to solve and make sure that you build your expertise in that, because again, a Swamiji quote, be and make. If you do not have the expertise, you'll not be able to deliver value. At Dexterity, we define leadership as your ability to deliver value through whatever limited expertise you have. And that is why we educate a generation. Your ability to deliver value is leadership. And the limited expertise that you have, that goes up through your education. So make sure, as a social entrepreneur, as a leader in the society, as a contributor in the society, service is the goal and renunciation is something you are willing to do. And as you move forward with that, make sure that you continue to grow your limited expertise, because the more the expertise grows, the more value you can deliver. I have crossed my time limit by a minute and a half. I thank you very much for having me. My pranams to everyone again. And may Swamiji continue to bless us, and may we be his soldiers like Netaji, and an Azad Hind force of a new kind is built, wherein that army, it should be an army of intellectuals, an army of leaders, an army of soldiers, teachers, and contributors all across the country, so that we can actually live up to the true meaning of the lives and work of Swamiji and